Good day, my name is Dirk Dennis from Mutual Europe, and in this video I will show you how to install the software for our new XPRJET object printers. We bundled everything in one folder for your convenience. The software is reasonably simple to install. Most of it is, so this is the driver, the Windows driver I start with. It's a matter of right-clicking, next, 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 and of course giving your correct IP address to the machine, which is in my case this one. Setting as default is not a must we can do, but I'll skip that for now. So I will first install everything, but what is more important is that after the installation I will show you which default modes we recommend to use. Once you installed the driver, the second most important tool is the layer editor, which is also a matter of next, next, next. It's important to install everything first and then change the defaults, because certain things are unavailable if not all is installed. My layout tool is the third and last one. Like for example, if I install the driver and I do not install the layer editor, then I cannot set my driver to print to the layer editor. So all is installed. As you can see, two shortcuts are made. And something important I will first do is set the spool folder. I will create manually a folder in my C drive directly. Very important. Spool 661. Because I will use this folder for my demonstration. As you can see, C spool 661. And when I start the layer editor as a first one, the only default I need to change here is, well, I just made that particular spool folder. The default folder is quite deep inside a Windows user folder, which means if I would pass on all the exercises in my default folder, they would not work on somebody else, their computer, because of the name of the user. So I will just search for the folder I just created, spool 661, and if you copy all the exercises in an identical folder, you should be able to repeat them perfectly. So that's one. My Windows driver default devices, printers, and here it is. Manage, and we go to printing preferences. So the very first time you start this, you get the question which ink setup you are using. In my case, it was US 11 in the 6-color setup. And you can, of course, print directly, but the layer editor is such a nice tool that I will show most of the exercises combined with the layer editor. You see your artwork as an A shown here, and you see that the A comes out upside down. For me, it's easier to have a what you see is what you get scenario. And of course, leave the machine on full size. Fine color mode, because I'm using video recording now. This head gap function is a bit of a mystery to some users. What does it do? Very simple. This is fixed large dot and this is variable dot. If you have a low head gap, then the variable dot offers nice quality. If you have a large head gap because of a curved object, then the small dot could create inked mist, which is why we switch to a large dot for a more stable printing. What I will change in my advanced settings is the head travel, not full width, but only data width, which is as short as possible. And the vacuum fan I set to medium high. These are my defaults I will use for the exercise now. If I make them in my Windows settings, they will apply to every software which addresses them. One thing I forgot, in my layout tool, select a default printer. I see my IP address popping up. Okay. And in the layout and print tool, one more thing, unable to find the printer. We'll soon fix that. Printer setting, select printer 661, and you see the icon changing. Perfect. My Windows driver is now set to rotate 180, which is something that the programmers who made this software already took into account. So I want my software like Photoshop and Illustrator to print on the machine the same I get on the screen, which is why I did the 180. But I want it also on this one, so I should revert it back. So now everything is set. These are the default settings you can use, and we can go ahead with our exercises.